Hey friend, thanks for joining me this week on this YouTube video. I am going to set up a twofer. It's going to be one this week that's going to start on this topic, and then the one next week is going to dive a little bit deeper into it in case this is something that you've been thinking about, or it might be right up your alley in terms of what kind of growth you want to have here in 2022. So this week I'm diving into affiliates and influencers. Affiliates and influencers are things that we often hear a lot about, especially as small business owners, even online business owners. It's huge for the product industry as well. So I felt like it was a topic that needed two videos just to give you some place to start and to consider whether or not it would be the right thing for you. So affiliates and influencers, do they really work? Yes. They do if you structure things in the right way and you look for the right type of people. So affiliates, get a percent back on any clicks to purchase, right? So that's what an affiliate is. An affiliate is somebody who might have written a blog or might post and say, hey, my friend's got this great product. If you click here, you can get 15% off. That's an affiliate, right? Influencers do often use affiliate codes as well. Affiliates is a great way of getting started in your business if you're looking for some growth there. Influencers, though, are really, they're considered content creators. They design and create content that's meant to appeal to their audience. They know how their audience reacts. They know how to get the most views from their audience and the most response on any kind of product that they're going to market. So influencers are content creators because they create content that's specific to their audience for your business that's going to market your product or service, and that promotion is then tailored to their audience to make sure that they get the most out of their audience tailored towards your business. Now, really, absolutely, they're great. They do really work. Like I said, just depends on how you structure everything and setting it up. And I think that's very important to consider. Just like when someone hires, another person to help them build their business, they need to make sure that the influencer or affiliate really aligns with your business and your goal. Do they have the right audience? Do they have the right style? Because sometimes influencers tend to have a very specific style. Are they more appealing to outdoor living or are they appealing to indoor living? Are they travel bloggers? Things like that. So you really, really have to be specific and research the right kind of influencers to use for your business. And the same goes for affiliates. You definitely don't want someone to encourage people to purchase if they're not looking at the right audience or their style is completely different, or maybe they wouldn't even consider using your type of product on a consistent basis because that means that their audience wouldn't either, which is not going to yield you any sales. So really looking at those things are very, very important. So I would consider a couple of these tips when you're looking at hiring an affiliate, hiring an influencer or partnering with an affiliate to help market your business. Make sure they have good communication skills. I can't say this enough, because if they're not able to communicate with you, if they don't follow up, if they're not staying in touch and staying on top of things, then they're likely to be unreliable. And that can often burn a bridge for you, especially if the affiliate or influencer is a little bit newer. So make sure they have good communication skills. Do they respond back in a timely manner? Are they getting you information? Are they following up with you as much as you're following up with them? All of those types of things, good communication skills are very, very important. And it feels kind of trivial to say, but you'd be surprised how often we can easily miss out on those kinds of things. The other thing to consider is, are they giving you a timeline or professionalism? Influencers should definitely do this. Influencers usually have a timeline prepared, especially if they know what they're doing and they've done this before. They have a timeline. They're like, here's what you're going to get. Here's what to expect. Here's when I would post this. Here's when I'll do that. They lay out all of these details so that you feel like you know exactly what they're doing for your business every step of the way and exactly what you're paying for. It's a great way of getting a bird's eye view of everything that they're doing, and then it also gives you an opportunity to kind of follow up and touch base as you go to ensure that they're getting everything done as they promised. And so that's, for the influencers, right? But the affiliates are the same way. Are they professional? Do they communicate well? Are they responsive to you? Are they excited about the fact that you've reached out and asked them to do this? Having some excitement in your product and what you have to offer is huge. When I was first approached by one of the affiliates that I have, and that's Style & Co. Backdrops, I use their backdrops all the time now. I'm still an affiliate of theirs and still a promoter of their product because I absolutely love everything that that woman does with her business. And by that woman, I mean Bethany. I've even done a YouTube video with her here, interviewing her, talking to her about what she's doing and how she's really changing the game for backgrounds. And so as an affiliate, I was super excited because she reached out to me and said, "Hey, you know what? You've got a great audience. You've got a lot of photographers and people who would be interested. You teach people how to do flat lays. Can I send you some of my backdrops and see what you think? Maybe you could share a post or something about it, or let me know, what you think, and I could set you up with an affiliate link." She sent me free backdrops to initially start, and it was the best thing ever because then I was super excited. I was got some free backdrops, and I was like, "Hey, you know what? These are perfect. This is awesome. Having something that's magnetic, like that's perfect. Like it lays flat, and I don't have to do anything with it. I don't have to weigh it down or do anything weird. It just sticks to the board. Like perfect, right?" So as an affiliate, make sure that your affiliates are excited about what you have to offer and consider giving them a bit of the product because that's going to be a big piece in tying them into seeing how they want to do a blog and they want to tie in this affiliate link and they want to talk about it in their stories and they want to trickle it through their content. It's great long-term strategy for you. It's also great short-term strategy for them to get some additional income into their pockets promoting your product. So that's really the difference there, but the good communication is just as important. They may not have the same type of timeline. However, them putting the stuff out there, doing some blogs and things like that initially is great long term for you, and it's good for them as well. Some of the activities that you can also consider when you're looking at influencers or affiliates, blogging, email marketing and mentions. If they send out any kind of newsletter to their audience, having those mentions in there is important. Look to see if they might do some giveaways of your product. That's a great way of boosting follows back and forth on both pages for you, as well as your product being sold. Consider doing any feature in use type videos. And then, of course, do they provide video and photo options? Some of the influencers that I've worked with in the past, they do. They give you an option to be able to purchase the additional photos and videos and things that they've taken, which gives you just that much more content to be able to utilize in the future. So, really, you can benefit from both sides. The same thing with affiliates. When you reach out to your affiliates and you want to connect with someone to be an affiliate of your product, ask them, if they're going to be okay with you mentioning those things, if they're going to put it in email, where they might put it, in their blogs and things like that. If they've taken any photos, do they mind that you share those photos as well? I've had photos of me shared on other pages just to kind of show off the things that I've done, and they want to show it in action as well. So think about those kinds of things back and forth. What do you want from the relationship? What are they willing to give from the relationship? And how best does it work for you and your business? It's okay to be a little bit selfish because while they're doing something for you, it also still has to reflect and work really well because you're giving something to them as well. You're giving them, free product, you're giving them access to your business, or in some cases with the affiliate link, you're giving them a certain percentage back to be able to earn money themselves. So it's okay to be a little bit picky and to give them some borders or some maybe guidance and direction on how to use your product, where you want to use it, those types of things to really encourage them to be the best type of source for you when it comes to your sales. And then, of course, to finish this up, just the last little sticky thing that sometimes comes up when people have been a little bit adverse to hiring an influencer or maybe they're not sure about an affiliate. I've got two tips to keep yourself from feeling like you're ever going to get burned in a situation. First, when it comes with influencers are generally paid. So with them, I would recommend doing a deposit. There's no problem with asking, like, hey, their total package might be $1,500. And I would say, you know what? How do you feel about we do $750 now so that we can get started on the planning, creating things, and getting stuff going? And then once you've launched like the first two or three campaigns in a couple of weeks, then I could pay you the remaining balance. That way, you know for sure they're going to show up equally as much as you're going to. And it gives everybody a little bit of skin in the game to make sure that everything goes kosher and everyone is happy at the end of the day. The next thing with affiliates is to give them materials. Affiliates will often promote continually and with ease on all of their platforms and social media if you give them resources. So in my case, free products is a great resource for me to be able to then take photos and be able to share and talk about the backdrops. For other people, it could be, sending them the skincare box so that they can see it, test it out, talk about it, try it, do an unboxing. Giving them video suggestions or photo ideas is very, very helpful, or even giving them templates and things that they can use. Just make sure to keep it where it's set up that they can customize it to their brand, but giving them that material, giving them some copy ideas or copy clips that they can use for captions, all of those types of pieces that make it easier for an affiliate to promote something for you will ensure that they're going to be more likely to do it. And then there's no harm in touching base with them just to check in and say, hey, you know what? It's been a couple of weeks. I just wanted to see how things are going. I thank you so much for mentioning my product. I hope the affiliate link is working well for you. I see that you earned an extra 50, 100 bucks last month. Let me know if there's anything I can do to help you maybe step that up a little bit and get you $150 to $200 each month from that affiliate link. I've got some great new materials, or I've got a couple of ideas where we could do a joint video or anything together. So think about those things and get very unique with it, especially if it's someone that you see the potential and being a great resource for you. And that way you make the most out of having an affiliate or an influencer. But all in all, this year it'd be a great opportunity to take a look at doing either one of those two as another avenue to grow your business. And if you like what you heard today, make sure to stay tuned for next video next week. Click subscribe below so you get the notification. And if you have any questions, leave me a comment. I'm happy to answer, and hope that you will consider having an affiliate or an influencer sometime this year.